Hi, welcome to What's New with Carcassonne. Today let's go over the mini expansion, Halflings.
It is recommended that you remove the
sheep, hill, crop circle, and vineyard half tiles. Shuffle the remaining tiles. Then each player draws three half tiles, looks at them, and sets them face down in their play area. When it is your turn, instead of drawing a tile from the usual draw pile, you can instead use one of your half tiles. And half tiles are placed according to the normal rules. City must touch city, field must touch field, road touch road, but only on one of the proper sides. You would not be able to place the long side against a field. You would have to put it like that, so that only a half a tile is missing. But in the future, it is possible to place a long side along another half tile's long side to create a full-sized tile. When a half tile gets placed, you can place a meeple according to the normal rules. And a meeple may also be placed to an adjacent half tile. When completing a feature, the entirety of the feature must be completed. There must be no gaps. So at present, this is 1, 2, 3 different cities. When the feature has no more gaps in it, that feature is then complete. And when scoring, each half is considered one whole. That is to say, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 tiles making up the completed city, which makes it 2, 4, 6, 8 points for the tiles, and then the 2 points for the shield. And likewise, this road is not complete until the other half tile completes it. However, a monastery is considered complete as long as there's one half tile in one of the spaces, and is worth 1 point, so you get the full 9 points for this monastery. And scoring does not change if you have two halflings in a space, it is just a full space now. And that includes the monastery itself being a half tile. And for endgame scoring, a half tile is considered a full tile, so this monastery would gain 6 points, whether a half or full tile occupies that space. And as for farmers, gaps always break up a field. So black owns this field and red owns this field. If the final tile of the game is drawn and a player still has a half tile in their play area, that half tile is now unable to be used. Before we go, let's go over the expansion tiles. When a monastery is completed, a vineyard gives 3 extra points. If using a hill, first draw a tile from the usual stack and place it underneath. The other half can be filled later with another half tile. Then place it according to the normal rules. And if there is a tie for ownership of a feature, the one on the hill is the one that breaks the tie and gets all the points. For the sheep tile, you need materials included in the 9th expansion, and you earn 3 points for sheep on this tile if you guide your flock to the stable. A wolf cannot scatter your flock. The crop circle half tile is played differently than a regular crop circle tile. When placing a crop circle half tile, first say what type of meeple, whether it's one in the city, the road, or the field. Then say whether to add a meeple to that feature where you already have a meeple, or remove a meeple from that feature from somewhere on the board. And starting from the player from that player's left, they will do so, ending with that player. If one of those players is unable to complete that action, they simply do not do that action and play passes to the next player. Until you are able to do so, then play continues as normal. Before we go, one starting alternative is to determine which player is first, then the player who goes last first chooses one tile.
Then, continuing in reverse turn order, each other player drafts a tile.
And continue doing so, still placing them face down in front of you. Continue until everybody has 3 tiles. Then begin play. Or continue drafting until you've reached the predetermined amount. Thank you for joining me to learn what's new with Carcassonne, the Halflings mini expansion. I invite you to join me now as I do a playthrough, then give it my Mega Carc ranking. And welcome back to Carcassonne. Today, of course, we are doing the Halflings. So I have here player 1 and I have here player 2 because my name's Richard, my wife's name is Jen. That's been done before, so I just go player 1, player 2. And We have our regular seven meeples as usual. I'll set those aside. We have our abbots, which I love playing with. And we have the halfling tiles. So each player doesn't know what the other has. So we're just going to set those aside in our play area, and we can choose to play these instead of drawing a tile. Perhaps there's something we would really like to get accomplished, or whatever it is, what have you, and so forth. So that is that. We also have out here our scoring track. It's the scoring track. Okay. So what we're going to do is, well, player one has three super secret tiles. So very, very secret. So tiles, oh, come on. Okay. So tiles are half, of course, and they are laid out so that the long sides are against each other and otherwise are still placed regularly. So I wouldn't, obviously, I wouldn't be able to do that, but I could still do that. That connects the field and road all together. That's all fine. And if that were to happen, well, that could not go there because that needs to be a field. But this does finish this road. So the feature here is indeed completed. So not completed, but it stops here. The road is the road. You don't need a full tile, and it still counts for the full amounts of points because it's the feature that's completed, not the tile that's completed. So, Anyway, so I don't know. Let's get on with it. Hey, let's get on with it. So let's have just player one. So these are super secret. That's not going to guarantee me to get anywhere. I mean, I could do that, but this is a little early to already be playing one of those. So I'm just going to go ahead and boom, I get a city. So let's try that this time. See what ends up going on and take the points. Yeah, take the points. I'll take 1, 2, 3, 4 points. Oh, okay, whatever. Player two is, of course, going to take this city. What does player two have for the halflings? Because they're not going to use them right now either. Oh, we can guarantee ourselves to end a road. So the half tiles are played instead of a tile. So you have to know what you have and say, I'm going to use a tile instead of drawing a tile. If at the end of the game you still have tiles left over, that is, well, too bad. You don't get to use them because the game is done when the last tile of the draw pile is drawn. So if you have any left over, like halflings left over, well, too bad. You don't get those potentially extra points. Player one. Well, let's start doing this right away. Player two. Road, just whatever. Draw, not draw a road, but player two, maybe do that. Player one, road. Okay, because I mean, I could, no, I couldn't. Oh, yes, I could. I could do that. And that would get me into that city. I could do that, and that would get me into that city. But I already played my tile down, so I'm not going to go back on that. But that would be one potential. Oh, look. Now I have those, a way to get into your city. Haha. But like I said, I'm not going to do that. So player two, who has one of these? What do you want to do? Maybe just put it up there. Let's put one up there. One. Yeah, let's just do that. Right? You know what, if I was smarter, maybe I would have used this and placed that there, and then, boom, you're guaranteed to go into that city and claim the city. Oh, well. So player two. Wasn't that handy? Actually, I'll put the abbot. Yeah, player one. Okay. So I was thinking maybe there's a way that you can put this there and maybe put that there and then put a meeple there and then maybe go into that city. I don't know. I'd feel better if I was by red rather than by green if I did that. So I think for now, my time will come. My time will come. So I'll just continue that. Whatever it is. So player two. Ah, that's fine with that. Let's do that. That also helps for the monasteries as well. Let's take our meeple. Let's draw straight. Let's do that. You know what? Two, three. City's already looking good. Too bad. I'm taking it. Too bad. One, two. Can't do that, but I can continue this, which helps everyone out. Let's put a meeple here. Why not? So, oh, that is on the road. Green, stray road. Oh, let's keep this open. Player two, straight road. Let's do this. With only two maples. No, I don't want to clean that road yet. This one. Let's try this. Red. Oh, I can finish that city. Yes. Oh, and I need roads. This is just a... Oh, it is a... I could start a new city. No, I'll just finish this. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 4, red. Green. Wants to just finish this. Let's open more fields. That's four. Red. This is just roads. I can continue. What do I want to do? Let's do that. No. Yes, yeah, okay. So player green, also roads. Okay, that's fine. I can use that to my advantage. 2, 4, 6. Oh, points for green. 8 is 14. Oh, I have not been. There we go. We're at 10 to 14. And I just saw I need to stay zoomed out, so I will. Red. Wow. Too bad this isn't a curvy road. What do you think? Just do it. Two, three. Okay. Not on the road, on the Abbey. Yeah. Green. Oh. Ah, shoot. Sorry. Green is going to go. Oh. I'm just looking at this. Could I put this here? No, because I can't put something else. Okay, that's out. Okay, so green. Green wants to go into the city, but he wants majority. Let's make a mega city. Will it work? Red. I did this or this. Yeah. Green. Just loves opening up the fields. Okay, green. Let's put the abbot on. Red. Yeah, that is helpful. Okay. And red even has a meeple, so might as well take 3 points. This one is done, I just realized, so that's 9 points for that. 13 is 20 points. And these two are close to done. Put a meeple down. So, green. Interesting choice. Let's just build out our city here and also claim it as our city here. Red. I'm going to take my own points. Thank you very much. 8. 28. Well, fine then. Now what am I supposed to do with these? I guess we'll see in a bit. That was red, so green. Let's just see where that goes. Red. I do this. Or I could do this. Claiming a field would be weak. Unless I claimed this bigger field, which is not necessarily what I want to do. You know what? I'm just going to do that. Looking at my half tiles. I already drew a tile. I can't suddenly say, no, I changed my mind. Or don't put a meeple there and just claim the abbot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the road is 34, and 8 more for the abbot. 42, green, straight road. Let's just do that. Red. Just realized this was a claimed road, right? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. I really hope it's red's turn, because they're the one gonna go now. Yeah. Do you want the road? I don't know. I'm probably gonna make it to help that. Green. Let's just continue this, which helps the city and the whatever there. Red. Let's do that. Do I have the abbot? I do have the abbot. Green. And then I could guarantee close that off. Red. Down for that. Green. Well, if I use this for this, I'm not getting in anywhere. But I could maybe encroach on that city. Wahahaha. Now for this abbot, this is a tile. What I mean by that is, so this is a half tile, but when we're counting points around things, you know, that's worth 9 points, there's a piece in the center and you go around. A half tile is considered a full point. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4 for this abbot right now. If I were to put another half, it would still be 1, 2, 3, 4. So whether it's half or whole, a space is a space. Red. Oh. Okay. Play with that magic, man. I don't know what that means. Green. I could just put that there. Yes, indeed, I could. Maybe it's better. Maybe it's. No, I'll worry about the city. So put that there. I mean, at this point, I'll just claim the road. So, red. Another one. Yeah, that should be enough to probably close it off. Green. OK. Okay. I'm not sure what to do with this. Maybe I'll just put that there. Or put this here, help this out. This is my last meeple. No, I don't want to put my last meeple on a two road. Okay. Red. Okay. This is closed off on two spaces, as in it's the two spaces are claimed. You need to have a field, and that's what I pulled. So that's why that will go there. Green, curvy road. Curvy road. Think I'll just do this. I could put it down there, but I want that city to be closed off before I know what to put for a road. So, one, two, three. Red. Let's. Yeah, I guess. Green. And I even have meeple. Yeah, let's do that. Red, curvy. Do that. That's fine. That's fine. Green. Green's own curvy. Yeah, I'll just leave that. Red. Oh. Red. Okay, green finishes off this. And don't have a meatball, so there's no road claiming. So 9 points. 17 is 26. Red. Oh, can't put that there. So I can put that there. So 2 for 6, 2 for 6, 8, 10. That's 5. And we have our 50. Green. Oh, it's on 5. Get green. Do have a maple. I'll claim something. Oh, I can't use this. I already drew the tile. You know what? For my own sanity, I'm gonna put this here. This closes off this part of the city, and good luck trying to get, well, I have 2 points here. If this is uncompleted, you have 1 point. So, too bad. So, I just need to complete that, and that'll complete my city. That's right, my city. Green. Oh, this actually helps me out better here. So I'll do that. Red. So my city, which is not anyone else's, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 points. 5, 17. Yes, I know. A couple incomplete sentences. Green. That goes there. Yes, it does. Red. Road. Red. You know, I could just put this down here, help out the abbot. Like I said, this is a full point, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points. 1, 2, 3, fully empty spaces. So 6 points, 23. Green. Okay, whatever. Finish off this city. Give myself 3 meeples. So I'll go 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. A nice 20. That puts us at 46. Red. Yeah, red has no specific need for their half tiles. Red, it's not going to finish off that city. Red is starting a new city, perhaps. Yeah, okay. Start a new city. Maybe claim the field over there. Okay, so that was red. So green. Ugh. Green has a tile they can put there to complete that city. They just forgot before drawing the tile. Green is going to finish this. So that's lovely. So that's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. So we got 4, 10, and our own 50 tile. Whoopity-doo. Ooh, red. Oh, can put this on. Okay. You have a better chance finishing, do you? Before I say that, actually no. I know something green doesn't, but now they probably know it themselves. Green. The green road, yeah, the green road. Actually, this green road will be finished. This one. Let's do that. I haven't had it there, but I wanted it completed. I knew I would, so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for the road, and 9 for the abbot. That's 24. Ooh, right there. Okay, so red is placing this half tile. Oh, why did I not claim the city? Okay, well, I forgot to claim that city, even though I totally meant to, so there. So this is field lined up against field, and this is a half tile, so that was claimed, and that's a half tile that was claimed. That's one of the features of the halves. Green. Okay. Green really likes stretching out his field, so I guess. So red. Does want to get city, but doesn't want to cut off the potential for what you could put as well. Okay, so if I did this, I don't have enough tiles to finish a city if I do that. So this field stops there. That's probably not going to. This is a part of this field. So, okay, good. Red takes that. Green is always forgetting he has a half tile he wants to use. Green is going to do this, is this, that, and the other thing. Well, green wants to keep the city in his field. I mean, if we got a couple curvy roads, then this would connect this to that field. Do you take that risk? Ah, we're getting close enough. I'll just do it. Red. Oh, man. That's a better shot over here. Green And forgets about the half tile he wants to use. Green. Let's try that. Take one. I'll take this one, sure. Red. I just feel better, more like that's more likely to get completed. Okay, so green has a half tile he wants to use to get points and get a meeple back. It's not about the meeple though. Whatever, 2, 4, 6, 8. We both get a meeple back. Isn't that nice? 2 and 9. Okay, fine. Okay, so red is going to use this for this road, which will complete this road, which 1, 2, 3, 4, 35, and this completes this monastery. So we have 9 points for that. And as for the half tiles, player one has this one. Doesn't have to use it for anything and might not even get the chance to. So anyways, yeah, that's the one we chose out of the, how many are there? 24, 20? Anyways, 24, I think. Player one. Oh, this isn't even in this field yet. I need to get a road in this field. 4. 6, and we got red. And we got green. Just take the, 4, 6, 40, and red. Oh, could have. Oh, well. You don't know what you know until you know what you know, you know? I can get 3 points there. I can get 4 points here, but then that helps out green too much. So how about I do this and take the... Yeah, this doesn't mess anything up that's not already. Okay, so I'll take 3 points for that one. Green. I need a road for there. Green. Let's do the see what happens game. Red gets a curvy road. Oh, and that gives 2 points if I put that there, or gets 4 points if I put that there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Green, really hoping for. Bah. Bah, bah, bah. Bah. Or is there something not claimed? You know what? I'm not getting in this field anyways. Let's give myself 2 points instead of one. And finally, red gets the last tile because those half tiles were 5 instead of... Okay, that's not going there. Okay, so everything else is claimed, right? I just give myself 2 points. Okay. All right, so we got this left over out of the tiles that we have, of course. Let's count it up. Green is slightly behind. Let's go 1, 2 for green. Let's go, five. Yeah, that's 5 for the abbot, 47. That's 2 for that city. 1, 2 is at 49 fields. Okay, so fields. That would cut it off because fields are cut off at open spaces, but it's all connected in this case anyways. We even go up to here. Red didn't think about that. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, yep. Yeah. Seven for this field is 21. 1 and 20, which makes it a nice, cool 120. So we got red. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3, 4. And we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, completed cities in this field. 1, 2, 3. Right? 1, 2, 3. Not complete. Okay. 3 times 3 is 9. 120. Oh, wow. There we go. Thank you for joining me for What's New with Carcassonne, the Halflings mini expansion. I invite you now to join me as I give it my Mega Carc ranking. All right, what did I think about the Halflings mini expansion? Well, it adds just that extra little bit of strategy to it, right? Also, it guarantees you that you will be able to finish a feature. It's nice to have that little bit of guarantee, right? I don't know. I really want to say cromulent. I do think it's good that you have this nice little piece that helps you for sure finish off a feature, yeah? And it's going to count for the full amount of points. That it's the tile that's half. The points are not. Even a monastery, as long as there's a half, you're going to get the full points. So that's cool. It's nice to have that in your player area. Nice to have that guarantee. They're face down, so you do have to remember to even use them. So that's not the end of the world. But do I consider it essential? I mean, it's nice to have that guarantee of, I have a city that I need to complete. You know what? I'm just going to complete it. I'm going to get my meeples back. I have 3 meeples invested in this city. Boom. I now have 3 meeples finally. So not bad. Is it essential? I'm going to say no. However, you might as well play with it. All right. I'm rambling. So, okay. Thank you very much for joining me as I do the Halflings mini expansion. Have fun.